Here we have a kind of candlelight charger with all kinds of candles. And inside there are nickel cadmium batteries that have to be charged. And this one, only this one, works properly. When I take it out, switch it on, the candle starts to light up. And that's of course good anyway. But the whole circuit is quite poor, in my opinion, because of the following things. Here we have a light emitting diode that only indicates that there is voltage on these four chargers. That's not good. It should be a LED that indicates current. So when I take it out, the LED doesn't light up. When I put it in, the light lights up. And when I take the candle out here, the LED also lights up. So it only indicates voltage and not that these candle lights are really charged. So that's a problem. By the way, an interesting circuit. This shows more, but also a poor circuit. And here is the schematic in a certain way again. And inside that each candlelight we find nickel cadmium batteries, and they are both 1.2 volts together, 2.8 volts. That's enough to make a white LED. White LED, here are white LEDs, light up. And inside there is a kind of, I think, regulator here now in the middle of the screen that regulates a current. And also when you look inside here in this unit, you'll find many BC5 or 7 transistors or whatever transistors, NPN silicon transistors or perhaps PNP, that doesn't matter, that have a function in the charging process. But what I'm doing now is to take the charger out here and charge the circuit via a resistor. That can also work. Of course, there is no switch of moment. But anyway, when such a circuit is charged with a low current, that doesn't have to be a problem. So that's what I'm going to do. And I've scraped off here the chip, and also gonna do that here to make such a simple thing usable again. Of course, too much energy spilled on a very low quality Chinese product. That's very important. I want to keep this circuit alive, but in fact it is so extremely poor designed that it cannot work for say 10 years or so, or 15 years. It's too poor. Bad design. Only made in a very, very cheap way. In such a way that it cannot last for a long time. And of course my circuit also will not last for a long time. But I can in a certain way refurbish it, give it a somewhat longer lifetime. The amount of time that has to be spent on such a circuit to make it good again is in fact far too high. Anyway.